sound understanding of atomic structure is essential to unlocking the predictive nature of chemistry and the reactivity of elements. If we think about the subatomic structure, we need to think about those parts of the atom: protons, neutrons, and electrons. If we think about a structure, there were a lot of attempts to try to explain an atom. There was a pudding model, there was a simple solar model by Rutherford, but it really didn't crystallize until Bohr added quantum theory to the value. With the Bohr model, we have a nice, simple model that works. Sad part is it only works for hydrogen with one electron, but it's still a great way for us to look at atom structure. Interestingly, Bohr actually, along with Heisenberg, set up the experiment that disproved his own model. Later on, they came up with quantum mechanics, much more complex system to look at the atom structure, but is the current and best way to calculate atomic structure. Thinking about the Bohr model, we need to think about the subatomic particles and where they are. So using the simple Bohr model, we can really think about it as we would a solar system. For the sun, we have the nucleus. For the planets, we have electrons. In the nucleus, we have protons and neutrons. The protons are essential. The protons give us what element we ever actually have. So if we think about the number of protons, if we have one proton, it's a hydrogen. If we have six protons, it's carbon. This is the atomic number, and it gives us the element. If we think about neutrons, neutrons can be added to the nucleus, but changing the number of neutrons does not change the element. So if we have zero neutrons in a hydrogen, it is hydrogen one, or our normal hydrogen. If we have one neutron, all of a sudden it is hydrogen two, or deuterium. If we have two neutrons, it is now hydrogen three, or tritium. If we think about carbon, we have the same thing. If we have carbon, it's going to have six protons. If it didn't have six protons, it wouldn't be carbon. We can have six neutrons in carbon, and that'll make carbon 12. If we have seven neutrons, carbon 13. These are isotopes. We have different isotopes that have different masses. If we look at the last subatomic particle, electrons, electrons want to balance protons. In a neutral atom, you will have the same number of protons as you have electrons. Electrons have very little mass, so therefore they do not add to the overall mass of a molecule. Therefore, they do not add to the mass of an atom. If we think about the electron, if it's balanced in the case of hydrogen, hydrogen has one proton, so we would have one electron. If we have hydrogen with no electrons, then that hydrogen would have a positive charge, because we do not have a proton with a positive and an electron with a negative balancing each other. If we had two electrons in hydrogen that only has one proton, then we would have a negative one charge. When we look at this structure, the electrons are really what's going to be giving us our reactivity. And knowing the balance of electrons to protons can tell us the ion. If we have a positive charge, as in hydrogen plus, that's going to be a cation. If we have a hydrogen negative, one extra electron, then that's going to be an anion. We're going to use these two to help predict the reactivity of the elements. We're going to take this understanding of atomic structure, build on it throughout the course, and we're going to look at how it is embedded into the periodic table.